I discovered for myself that right or wrong, you know, it doesn't matter. For me personally, I need to have a certain amount of money in the bank to feel safe enough to make good decisions. And if that ever goes away, I go into freak out mode. And this is true in business, and this is true personal. And for me, that's about a year's expenses. So if there's a year's fixed expenses in the bank, I go, huh, okay. We can now wake up in the morning and do
Be
what we
aggressive.
want and be a little bit more, we can be on offense.
Absolutely.
And
Absolutely.
so I have my security, which is a year's fixed expenses in the bank, and then I have kind of a different level of security, which is a warehouse, right? So I put money into the warehouse so that it's growing along with the market, and that is like, it also has the death benefit. If anything ever happens to me, Esther's getting $3 million, right?
I would even go one step further is eventually your capital warehouse will have you'll be able to store enough in there that you would prefer to store inside of your bank account, you would store it there. Because it's got from a risk profile, I believe that the capital warehousing strategy is less risk than a bank. And the reason why is the bank is 0% and we're in an inflationary environment. So at very least with the capital warehouse, all we've got to do to be better than a bank account is outpace 0%,
Yeah,
1%.
right.
I mean, you can't
Yeah.
do that all at one point. Like you can't put a year's expenses in at one point because it takes time to build
Well,
that
I
up.
mean that depends. I
Yeah.
mean, to be perfectly frank, my year's worth of expenses is like, you know,
Well then,
$150,000. So
correct.
you could put that in a
Absolutely,
warehouse in a
absolutely.
year
Without a
or
doubt, without
two,
a doubt, yes, sir.
right? So it's so weird to say that because there's some people who are like, why does Ryan live so frugally? And then there's somebody else that's like, how could you possibly spend $250,000
Well, it
a
depends on what part of the country you're in. If you're
year?
in
Right.
California, you're thinking 150 popper time, but
Yeah, just come to Whole Foods with me on a Friday night and you can see how you can spend $250,000 a year.
Oh,
But anyway,
geez.
so I've got my base amount, which is a couple $100,000, like as my,
Cushion.
yeah, as my year's worth of expenses. And then I have the warehouse, which I'm building up over time, which by the way, that if you've ever heard Tony Robbins talk about asset classes that go up with the market but don't go down, that's a warehouse. So I'm putting my money there. Then with 10% of my take-home money from my businesses and my other investments, my total take-home money, I have it set, E-Trade automatically takes 10% every single
Awesome.
month. Every single month, 10% of my take-home dollars goes to E-Trade. I don't even do anything with it once it hits E-Trade. It's just going into E-Trade so that I can buy dividend-paying stock when I see a dividend-paying stock that I want to buy. And by having it automatically go there, I'm doing the habit of putting it into a smart play. That gives me a remainder of, you know, 75% of my money, because 10% is going to E-Trade, a certain amount is going into the warehouse. I got the rest of my money to play with, and that's where I am looking for what you said, active cash flow creating asset classes. And the three things I look for are, does it produce cash flow from day one? Does it have the opportunity to go up in value over time? And does it give me protection against taxes? I'll throw one more bonus in there is, do I have access to the, do I, can I access the money quickly? If I can get two or three of those four, I'm thrilled.